I've been here about, say, 15 years before the war. I make 16. 17 altogether. And I've been working the job for 8. I brought down, say, 3 times as many men. It's a big figure, I know. Don't worry. It isn't like they weren't deserving of it. My brother says I should retire. Maybe. Folk talk a lot about this place and what's been going on in these times. Some say it was the fall. A power vacuum that left it like this. I entertained that at first. Now I'm not so sure. It could be it's always been like this. And only now is it starting to show.
Well played, friend. Well played.
Gentlemen, I trust you are doing well this evening.
The job, Tarvin.
Ah, right. Here's the situation. 3 cycles ago, rumors began to move through the fief. The same sort as usual. Usually it's Bantha fodder, but every once in a while, fortune can favor the gambler. Someone caught wind of a cache of credits in a dead oasis past the Pike Tract.
This is one of these faded instances?
My brother thought so. He's a smart man, but Well, the solidarity this lifestyle breeds can tool with the best of us. He's been living with me on the ranch since the war ended, and, well, I suppose he got restless.
You want us to find him?
Yes. As men of your profession know, where, if there's money, there's bound to be trouble. I need you to go and make sure he's all right.
A trek across that desert is no small feat.
I'll pay well. Just name your price.
1,500.
1,800.
All right. But you must set off tonight. Every hour he spends in that desert could be his last.
As you wish.
Don't come any closer. I'm armed. See? Oh. Harry's gun. You scared me half to death. I nearly put a hole in you. What are you doing in a place like this?
Oh, I could ask the same of you, old friend.
Oh, hi. The morning stroll, I suppose. Head needed clearing.
Yeah, well, suppose my being here isn't of the same nature as yours.
No?
No, sir. I'm on the trail.
You're speaking like a younger man. I was under the impression that you'd laid down the armor long ago.
Yeah, well, the death of Ed Flint requires that I pick it back up.
Ed's dead.
I found him a couple of hours before sundown. Accosted on the roadside, stripped of his cash, his belongings, and murdered. He even took the late wife's necklace, the bastard.
He never did take that thing off.
It seems the handiwork of a professional, but the sloppiness in fleeing the scene would suggest otherwise. I'd pick him a out-of-work mercenary. Desperate man. That makes him dangerous. You had dealings with any mercenary types lately?
Bounty hunters.
Effectively.
No. I don't consort with men of their status. Uncivilized types.
Right. Well, the trail leads through here, and most likely across the pack tract. Come midday, I'll be on his tail. Afternoon, I'll be on him. By dusk, he'll either be in my captivity or lying dead on the sand. His mission incomplete.
An unfortunate fate.
Yeah. Well, fate isn't kind to men that think themselves above the law. I'll be seeing you, old friend. Don't go getting yourself into trouble.
Take care, Arius. Damn it.
Hell. Do you think that...
Can't say yet. Follow close. Let's take a look.
Which one of these is the brother?
Forget the brother. Just look around. This is, at the very least, Triple Jack's offer. Easy, son. You don't want to do this.
Fate favors the gambler.
I don't want to.
Drop the gun or I drop you. First and final warning.
Walk away. You don't want any part of this.
Yeah. I think I do.
I'd stop right there if I were you. Good, good, good. What's your name, friend?
Folks call me Gun.
Gun. All right, Gun. How's it about we have ourselves a talk?
I'm all ears.
Good. You see, I've gotten myself into a bit of a predicament. I've acquired myself a considerable sum of money, but due to my current state, find myself without a way to transport it off-site.
Looks that way.
I'll make you an offer. You take me back across the pike track to the Fordham or the Erasmus Depot. I don't much care. And I'll give you half. How's that sound, Gun?
The necklace.
What?
The necklace. Where'd you get the necklace?
What is it? You know what? I'll throw it in too. Solastin silver. It'll fit you a good price.
Just tell me where you got it.
I bought it off an old merchant by the name of...
Flint. Ed Flint.
Yeah. Ed Flint. Old Ed Flint. I traded it for a couple of power converters.
No, he never would have parted with that. I knew him. That was his late wife's necklace. And you didn't trade with the man. You took his life.
Now, hold on.
Say it.
Now, I don't know what you're...
Say you killed him!
All right! I killed him! What the hell's it matter?
That's all I needed to hear.
You're not gonna pull the trigger.
Why's that?
You shoot me, I'll let the skull, all this, get blasted to high hell. You kill me, you lose the cash.
Sounds fair to me.